West Virginia has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Jayhawks.
Been talking with them this week, Kirk. It's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself. And I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'll be shocked if they can slow him down.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. And he just gets rid of it. Stop at the 29. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
He really got a hold of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Like a couple of boxers in round one, these two teams are feeling each other out.
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game. Let's see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
Excellent open field tackle. Throws this one away. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Where's 52? Lock 52. She's the mic. Go.
He's got an opening. He's tackled at midfield.
Terrific execution by the entire offense to make that run work and to get the third down conversion.
Running back's got it. Brought down around the 33-yard line.
Impressive gain there by the do-it-all back.
Quick throw, almost intercepted.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
From the 33-yard line, second down. Heading for the corner. Tackle at the 10. Quick out to his receiver. Touchdown, Mountaineers. On the extra point. A 7-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. West Virginia's really got things working right now for them. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
He gets gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Red, two, go!
He airs it out. And he stays in bounds, and he hauls in a big one.
Gaining 47 on play. First down.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Three down.
31's the mic.
Red.
Inside give. Hello. Nice to meet you.
Rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. Quickly, and that was almost picked.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
It's up, looks long enough, and he nails the long field goal. Set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And they can forget about returning this one. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. West Virginia holds a 4-point lead. Grabs it and hammered right there. An empty backfield with five wide receivers. Pass complete and taken down immediately. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36-yard line.
Wow, that was close. I think the officials marked the spot correctly, and it gives them the first by an eyelash.
And he's tackled around the 37-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and nine.
He's scrambling. He's at midfield, slides down, and he has a huge gain.
Yeah, I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks, he sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off, ends up with a great run.
Has some daylight.
They get about 6 yards on the option to the halfback.
Six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Where's 52? Watch 52.
Room around the corner. And he's level at the 29-yard line. West Virginia is up four. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. Got his receiver, touchdown.
I like how the quarterback, the offensive line, and the receivers made a concerted effort to get into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
The score now, 14-3. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. West Virginia's defense really came to play early in this football game.
Well, they've done a good job here early, but you know eventually this offense is going to start clicking. Let's see if this defense can sustain this for the rest of the game.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Out of bounds around the 29-yard line.
Second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on the 29. Now he's scrambling. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. And it's almost picked off. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Oh, man, he took him down hard. The Mountaineers are punching it into the end zone when they get the chance, and that's been the difference so far in the ballgame.
Yeah, give them all the credit. It's one thing to move the football down the field, but when you get an opportunity to come up with a touchdown, you have to capitalize on it, and they've done that.
As we change ends of the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. The Mountaineers in front by 11. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Caught, and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
Taken down at the 45. They'll bring him down right around the 26-yard line. Slings it, and down he goes, right around the 14-yard line. Steps out of bounds, around the 8-yard line.
An offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that? Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
From the 14-yard line, third down.
Yeah, let's go sack lunch.
That's a great tackle at the 25-yard line. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
He gets gets it up, and he splits the uprights.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
17-3, West Virginia. He just drills this one, and it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Got it, and he goes down quickly. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, and somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
And that brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. West Virginia's offense really had a goal in that first quarter, but they're starting to struggle here in the second half.
Well, because they played so well early in this game, even though they have been struggling, they still have a pretty comfortable lead. Now let's see if they can hold on to it here as we get ready for the second half.
They're set to go for another round. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. 2 yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That brings up third and 12.
From their own 37-yard line, it's third down.
No, check that. We're on Mike 52 right here. Go! Check.
He wants it all going long. And it's caught, and he's taken down at the 7.
You can chalk that one up to the hundreds of passes the quarterback has thrown to this receiver in practice. These guys know and trust each other, and you could see it in the way he threw that pass.
Fires out to his receiver, and a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Makes it 3 touchdown passes this half.
Defense better make some adjustments, and they need to make them now because this passing attack is making a highlight film right now.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 4-play, 60-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. So the score now, 24-3. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Jayhawks know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
Green nine, go!
And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 25-yard line. Third down. He's to the 40. Pulls it in. First down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
That's good decision-making there and mechanics by the quarterback. He knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but he looked off the other receivers first.
Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 40-yard line, first down. Get to that quickly. He's tackled at the 39. He goes out of bounds, right around the 36-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. Sack. The pressure was just too much to handle that time as this defensive end was able to sack the quarterback.
They came with a blitz, and this time it worked out. The quarterback had no open receivers, and he just went down.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. Slings it out, and it gets tipped. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
From their own 49-yard line, second down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. They get 3 yards on the play.
This kid's just a sophomore. He'll learn how to break those short catches in the big games.
Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. First and 10, all in the 29-yard line. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was in bounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after review, they decide that this call should be reversed. Catches it. Quick strike, and he drops it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. For it all to the the end zone. Leaps picked off.
There you go. If you've got to come back in this game, it's going to start with one play. And maybe that pick is what turns things around for you.
Gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Kill, kill. Panther two. Motion, motion, motion.
Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle around the 21-yard line. He scrambled and maybe picked up a yard there.
And that was the junior corner who'll get credit with that tackle.
From their own 21-yard line. Third down.
Three down, three down.
Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47.
Black 5, black 5.
Go.
Blue 20. Go.
Steps up, throws it deep. Incomplete. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Mountaineers with a 3-touchdown advantage.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports Halftime Show. Reese Davis and David Pollack here at the break. David, you go through this first half, and there was a lot of anticipation for this game coming in, but it sort of got sleepy. It was sort of, as scripted throughout the first half. What's it like for a player when a game's sort of gone flat on you to try to maintain that edge?
Well, you always have so much emotion and so much excitement coming into a ball game, and a lot of times it's about tapering it down and making sure you don't use it all in the first half. I think you saw the feeling out process, and now in the second half you'll start to see that energy pick back up, because now you're going to see the goal in sight, the finish line's coming, and guys are going to make sure they want to make plays.
Have to try to maintain a fine balance between the desire to make plays and staying within yourself, sticking to the game plan, and perhaps that will be the key to the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. It's the tailback. Caught over the middle. And they make the stop at the 29-yard line. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
Fires it out. He gets hit out of bounds at the 45-yard line. And they push him out the 39-yard line. Really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Throws this one out to the right. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver.
You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
Kicks away.
And the kicking team goes to the sideline very disappointed. So we'll change possession with a score, 24-3, West Virginia. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on their own 37. Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. Nice pitch and catch for the first down.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
From the 48-yard line, first down.
47, Mike. 47, Mike. Mike, 47.
Green. Sets up a screen. Incomplete.
Number 19. That makes it second and 10.
Right here, right here.
31's the mic.
Green 9, green.
They'll give it off here. Tackle made at about the 47-yard line. And he gets a yard on the run.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
Third down again.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Throws it to the outside. Great catch, and he's out of bounds. Caught with room to work. Fires out to his wideout. Brought down at the 50-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Snags that one. And down he goes at about the 21.
Anytime a running back gets one-on-one with a safety, I think that running back has the confidence in his own athletic ability to be able to make that safety miss and get upfield for some yards. That time, the safety just dominated him, made a great tackle in the backfield for a short loss.
Swatted away.
Wow, did you see that? I don't know how he got his hands up in time to knock that pass down.
Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. He gets it up, and he got it. West Virginia gets set to kick this one away. Excellent kick. Jayhawks have just gone ice cold on offense. They can't seem to get anything going.
Right now, they just have to forget the score, forget the clock, just go out there and try to get a first down, try to hope to build a little bit more confidence and continuity on this offense.
Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 25.
Red two. Easy, easy.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Tackles him hard at the 15. Fourth and long here after the sack. Oh, excellent punt. What a game it's been for this quarterback, Kirk.
Well, he's putting up huge numbers, and I think you can go back and look at every throw that he's made. It's like a human highlight film in one football game.
All of his success has led to their advantage on the scoreboard. The offense gets set to take the field. Last time out, they stuck it between the uprights for three. Throws complete. He's hammered. And a pickup of about seven.
Here the defense is sitting in man-to-man coverage. The quarterback saw the receiver get a small opening, and he's able to deliver the ball for a nice game.
Quick throw, and he's taken down right around the 34. Pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He's taken down at the 29.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. Third down.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Throws a dart to the right. Nice catch. First down, and he's knocked out. That's three down and one to go. West Virginia's got a 24-point lead. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. It out to him again. There's another. And he adds the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Early in the fourth quarter, and this one we know is over. It's an opportunity for some subs to play on one side and maybe to play for pride on the other.
Oklahoma!
Five yards.
You don't have have to go deep every play to be successful. They got 5 yards on the play, and that's always a good game.
We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 30-yard line.
31's the mic. Watch the run. Watch the run.
Dog 4.
He's to the 40. Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again. He's tackled at the 42-yard line.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Get that ball, D. Let's get that ball. Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike.
Red, go!
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Now he's scrambling. Tackle at about the 49.
Game of 7 yards. That makes it third and 3.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Three down.
31's the mic.
Black pit.
They keep it on the ground and get the first down.
Give credit to the big boys up front. They did an excellent job of allowing the back to get nice yardage there.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 47. Check Mike 47. Red 2.
And he throws it away.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 45-yard line, second down.
Here we go.
Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Number 16 on the coverage.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. He wants it all, going long. Missed him. I thought they might have had a score right there.
I think the quarterback hesitated a second too long, and that's why the pass went incomplete.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. West Virginia has proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys you normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play-calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
From their own 33-yard line. First down. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Makes it out to about the 43. To about the 41-yard line.
Game 16. That's good enough for another West Virginia. First down.
From the 41-yard line, it's first down. They go right back to him, and this time they get him in the backfield.
Loss of 4 on the play. That makes it second and 14.
Gets to about the 44-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
Down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Well, a nice
stop there late in the fourth quarter, but it's a blowout and has been for most of the game. I think it's time for everybody to go home. And so that's going to do it. The Mountaineers come out on top, 34-3. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.